Rod Serling.
There is a fifth dimension beyond that which is known to man. It is a dimension as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between light and shadow, and it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge. This is the dimension of imagination. It is an area which we call the Twilight Zone.
Say?
He said the bus to Hart City.
Hartford? That us?
No, dear.
When's our bus?
I don't know, Edward. Why don't you ask?
Ask who?
The nice man at the ticket window.
I want a window seat.
Yes, dear.
If they don't give me a window seat, I'm not going. I'll stay right here on this bench all night if I have to.
You can't do that. They won't let you.
Won't let me sit by the window? Then you go on without me, Eleanor.
Pardon me.
Oh, hello, dear.
I'm sorry to bother you.
Not at all.
Are you waiting for the Cortland bus by any chance?
What did she say? Portland?
Portland, Maine, or Portland, California?
Neither, I'm sorry.
We're going to the Elder Hostel in Fort Ritchie. My friend Mary went there last year, and she said it was lovely.
I'll ask at the window. About your bus, too, if you like. Do you mind if I leave my suitcase here, just for a minute?
Of course, dear. Oh, you know that.
Thank you. I'll be right back. Excuse me. The bus to Cortland.
What about her?
It was due a half hour ago.
Yep, a half hour ago.
When will it be in?
It's kind of hard to say. Road slick, maybe a bridge or two out. That's bound to screw up the schedule.
Well, do you have any idea when it'll be in?
She'll be in when she'll be in. That's all. I told you that the last time you asked, miss.
The last time? The last time I asked you was right now. Look, all I want is a civil answer from you.
You're getting a civil answer, miss. Trouble is, every 10 minutes, you're up here requiring one. The situation just doesn't change that rapidly. You want to know about the Cortland bus? It's late. It was late when you first asked me a half hour ago, late when you came back 15 minutes later, and it's late now. All the asking in the world ain't gonna push it, none.
This is the first time I've been at this window to ask. Either your eyes are bad, mister, or...
My eyes are fine. I don't have any trouble reading the timetables, now do I? Maybe you're the one with the problem. Maybe you don't hear very well. Or maybe you don't remember things. Maybe you'd best see a doctor about that memory of yours.
I don't need to see any doctor. Now, I've had just about enough of this conversation. Goodbye. And you needn't worry. I won't bother you any further.
Here she comes again.
Are you all right, dear?
Yes, I'm fine. Oh, I forgot to ask for you.
Ask about what?
Your bus. You wanted to know about the one to Fort Ritchie.
Oh, we don't need to know.
You don't?
I found that schedule you brought us before.
That's nice. I'm glad, but I didn't bring it to you.
What did she say?
Oh, but you did. The first time you came over. You didn't ask us to watch your bag then.
My bag? Yes, here it is.
You were going to the window, but you didn't want to leave your bag here. Not the first time.
And you're saying I spoke to you on two different occasions?
That's right. About your bus. Is something the matter?
No. No, nothing's the matter.
Millicent Barnes, age 25, young woman waiting for a bus on a rainy November night. Not a very imaginative type is Miss Barnes, not given to undue anxiety or fears, or for that matter even the most temporal flights of fancy. Like most young career women, she has a generic classification as, quote, someone with a head on her shoulders, end of quote. All of which is mentioned now because in just a moment The head on Miss Barnes's shoulders will be put to a test. Circumstances will assault her sense of reality, and a chain of nightmares will put her sanity on the block. Millicent Barnes, who in 1 minute will wonder whether she's going mad or whether she's just stumbled into the Twilight Zone.
And now, the Twilight Zone and our story, Mirror Image, starring Morgan Brittany and Frank John Hughes, with Stacy Keach as your narrator.
Well, shall we run through it again?
Thank you, no.
Good.
I wondered, I just noticed.
Noticed what?
That the bag in there.
Where?
In the baggage room behind you. That bag, the one on the floor in front of the others.
What about it?
Well, I'd like to see it.
You would?
Yes, it looks familiar.
What is this, some kind of game?
No game, honestly. It looks just like mine. It's identical, even to the handle being torn, the red name tag, the sticker on the side.
Lady, that is your bag. You checked it.
That's not my bag.
You want it back?
It looks just like mine, but it's not. It can't be. That's my bag over there by the bench.
Is it?
The bench against the wall, at the end where I was sitting. Oh.
Uh-huh.
My bag was there, but it's not now.
That's because you checked it.
Well, how did... Then I'd like to uncheck it, if it's mine, as you say.
Claim check, please.
What?
All you have to do is show me a claim check. The one I gave you when you checked the bag.
I don't have one. Here's my bus ticket, my wallet, my keys, and the rest. See, that's all I have in my purse.
No claim check, no suitcase.
But that's absurd. You just said it's mine.
Nothing I can do about that. State law.
When I saw it in the baggage room just now, I'd swear that was the first time I...
Why don't you just go over there and sit down, miss? You're either walking in your sleep, or you're hungover, or something. Just go back there and sit down and breathe through your nose and let me read my magazine. When the Cortland bus comes, there'll be a loud noise, a door opening, and people will come in here. And then you'll know the bus has arrived.
But I never checked my bag. I don't feel very well. Where's the ladies' room?
Straight across the lobby, other wall.
There goes that girl again.
I see her, Edward.
Can't make up her mind, can she? Must be on some kind of drug.
Oh, you hush now.
I'll be finished cleaning the floor in a minute, honey. You go right ahead.
Thank you.
Are you all right?
Yes. Yes, I'm all right. I'm perfectly all right. Why, don't I look well?
Why, no. Honey, you look fine. You look just fine. Just like when you came in before.
What do you mean, before?
You were in here just a few minutes ago, remember?
That wasn't me.
Sure was, honey. Same coat, same little rain hat. That was you, for sure. Not that many people in the station this time of night. Plus, I never forget a face.
Look, I don't know what's going on around here. Somebody takes my bag, somebody says I'm always asking questions about the bus. Now you tell me I've been in here before and...
Just take it easy now. Everything's going to be all right.
Well, of course it is. There's nothing wrong to begin with. There isn't a thing wrong. I think the only problem around here is that you people need some sleep or something. You say I came in the ladies' room.
Big as life.
And then I suppose I walked back out into the waiting room, right into this very door.
So far, yeah. Here, wanna try?
Oh, thank you.
This guy's easy, though.
Let me get you a cold cloth, honey. I don't think you're well.
I don't need one, thank you. I must be overtired. That's it. But I'm gonna be fine. Now, let's... Just do a quick reality check. Look out there.
What for?
Tell me what you see.
Okay.
Now, tell me about the woman. Tell me if...
No woman.
Are you sure?
All I can see is a kid playing a video game.
Hi.
Oh, hi. I'm on level 13 again.
That's nice.
Whoa.
I wanted to ask you, who are you talking to just now?
Who do you think? Want to play, huh?
Play?
There goes. I lost. Oh, well.
I might have another quarter in my purse.
Four's enough.
Is it?
That's what you gave me already. I still got two left.
Of course. And that was just a minute ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, when you're coming out of, you know...
The ladies' room?
That guy at the window. He won't give me change, but you did. Four quarters for a dollar. Thanks.
You're welcome.
So you want to play?
You mean, like before?
You didn't play me before. You said some other time. Well, want to now?
This game, it's called Tomb Raider.
Cool, huh? There's the graveyard. When the dead people come out of the ground, you have to shoot them before they get you. Or a tombstone pops up with your name on it. See?
After I was standing here talking to you, where did I go? Did you see exactly?
How come?
I'm trying to retrace my steps. I think I lost something.
Same place you were sitting before. Over there on the bench. Where the suitcase is.
The suitcase? Yes, of course. It has to be mine. Right where I left it. On the floor.
Last chance.
For what?
Last game of the night. Before they shut off the machine.
Some other time.
I gotta go home anyway.
Home. Yes, you do that. Time to go home. Here. Right here. And the tag with my name on it. How can that be?
Miss?
Yes, what do you want?
Your wallet. I think it fell out of your purse.
Oh, thank you. I must have dropped it over there somewhere.
You did. I saw it, so I brought it over. Person can't get very far without a wallet now, can they?
Thank you again.
Thank you. You mind if I share your bench?
No, I don't mind.
Bus is late, isn't it?
It seems to be. It's over half an hour late now. You mean the Cortland bus, don't you?
That's the one. I was supposed to be in Syracuse by 10. Planes were all grounded. Took a cab from Binghamton. Darn thing skidded and ran into a tree just a few miles outside of town. Had to walk back to the bus station there.
That's quite a story. You look awfully wet.
No kidding. I'm about 4 hours from Binghamton, and about 5 minutes away from pneumonia.
Is that right?
Forgive me, miss, but you're not ill, are you?
I don't know what's wrong with me. I really truly don't.
Well, is there anything I can do?
I don't know how to answer that. It's just that a whole bunch of odd things have been happening.
Odd?
I've been... seeing things.
What sort of things?
I don't think I should tell you. I think you'll want to move to another part of the room if I do. Or call the police or an ambulance or something.
Why don't you take a chance and tell me? You never know. I might be able to help.
I don't even know you.
Oh, sorry. Paul Grinston. I'm from Binghamton.
Millicent Barnes. At least I was.
And what does Millicent Barnes do?
I'm a private secretary. I quit my job here on Thursday, and I got another job in Buffalo, and that's where I'm going tonight. Well, trying to go to Buffalo. But everything I do, people keep telling me I've done it before. The man who sells the tickets, he said I kept asking him where the bus was, and the woman in the restroom, she said I'd been in there before, and I hadn't been. And my bag here. My bag! Where?
Right there, by the edge of the bench.
Oh, for a second there, I thought it was starting all over again.
I think you'd better tell me the whole story.
Well, that couple over there, the man and the woman and the ticket man, they said I'd checked it, and there was a bag almost identical to mine in the baggage room. I saw it. Then when I looked again...
Go on. Please.
Well, that doesn't make any sense, but when I was in the ladies' room, there was a voice from out here, and I thought I heard...
What did you hear?
My own voice. I thought I heard myself talking to someone.
Who?
That boy.
Where?
Oh, he must have gone home. You don't believe me, do you?
Well, I wasn't there.
It has to be some kind of a delusion. Do people have delusions that they can hear?
I don't know. I guess they could.
That's what they are, I'm sure. Some kind of delusions. But it isn't just hearing things and seeing things that don't exist. It isn't just that. Why did the old man selling tickets and that woman in the powder room and the couple on the bench and the boy playing the video machine, why did they all say they'd seen me before?
I can't say. That's a tough one.
What is happening? What on earth is happening to me? I must be sick. I must be running a fever, but I'm not even warm. I don't have a fever. No fever at all. Do I? Here, touch my hand. Can you feel me?
Yes, I can feel you. You're really here if that's what you're worried about, and you don't have a fever.
I'm not some sort of crazy person. Really, I'm not. I've never had any problem like this. I mean a problem with my mind or anything like that.
Of course you haven't. And there is an explanation someplace. There's a reason. Maybe
what?
Maybe there's someone here in this building who resembles you. Could be that, you know? Or maybe somebody playing a joke or something. Is that possible?
No, that's too fantastic. And that doesn't explain the bags or anything. If there was someone, where is she now? This is a small bus station. Where is that person?
When you get to Buffalo, will someone be there to meet you?
Why, yes, I think so. I'm sure of it. A friend of mine. She's supposed to pick me up at the station.
Maybe you should call ahead since we're running late. Let your friend know you won't be getting in for a while.
Yes, that's a good idea.
There's a payphone over there.
Good. Oh, but I only have one quarter, and that man at the window...
Here, this ought to be enough.
I can give you this dollar bill.
Forget it.
Oh, you're very kind. I'll be over there.
I'll watch your bag for you.
Thank you so much.
Good luck.
Would you do one thing for me?
Sure. What do you need?
I need you to ask the man at the ticket window something. Would you mind?
Not at all.
Ask him if... But you don't have to ask him. Just look over his shoulder into the storage room where they keep the bags and see if there's one that looks like mine. The same handle, the same kind of tag hanging off it exactly. And if there is, tell me. Would you do that?
No problem.
I'll be right back. $150, $160. Oh, I don't have that much.
Would you like to call collect?
Yes, that would be wonderful.
One moment, please, while I get your party on the line.
Hello?
Judy? It's me.
Where are you? Did you make your bus all right?
Yes, I made it, but now the connection is late, the one to Cortland.
Good thing you caught me. I was just on my way out the door.
It'll be a while yet. I guess it's the rain.
So when should I meet you?
That's just it. I don't know.
Tell you what, I'll call the bus station here and ask them what time it's due. As soon as I find out, I'll get in the car.
I'm so sorry to do this to you.
It's not your fault. Don't worry about it. I'll be there.
Thank you so much.
See you in a little bit.
Number 17 to Cortland, Syracuse and Buffalo. Now arriving at gate 2. All passengers, gate 2.
That's it. Judy, are you still there? Judy?
Gate 2, departing in 5 minutes. Need a ticket?
No, I've got one.
Luggage?
What?
You want to check any luggage?
All I have is this briefcase.
Go right through that door, then. Line's outside.
What time is it?
Oh, my God, it's finally here.
I thought we'd have to stay in a motel.
Hope the bridge didn't wash out.
Well, better late than never.
You can go now.
Right, I have to wait for someone. I think she checked her bag. Could you look? Medium size, leather handle with a red tag on it, and a sticker on the side?
You mean the young lady's?
I don't see it.
That's because she picked it up already. Took it through.
No, I don't think so. I don't see it back there, but it's possible she didn't check it at all.
Oh, she did all right. Picked it up as soon as I made the announcement, just before you walked up.
Wait a minute. That's not true.
No?
She went to use the phone.
Phone's over there. Nobody's using it now, see?
How can that be?
Glad to have her out of my hair, if you want to know. Real nervous type. Couldn't make up her mind. Number 17, Cortland, Syracuse, and Buffalo. Boarding now.
You are here.
Where did you think I'd gone?
To make a phone call, but...
I did, and now the bus is here, at last.
I guess we better get going.
Let me get my bag.
Your...
Right here, where I left it. Thanks for watching over it for me.
Let me get that for you. Looks heavy.
Oh, thank you. You're very nice.
No problem.
Really, you're being very kind to me.
Oh, forget it. You're easy to be kind to.
More than just kind. I mean...
Come on. We don't want to miss it.
Just set her down right there, ma'am. I'll put her in with the rest.
Be careful now. It's got all my prescriptions. Don't you lose it.
I won't lose it, ma'am. What goes in comes out. I'll even give you a claim check for it, okay? There you go.
What did he say?
Come along, Edward.
Hello, sir.
Hi.
Want that in here?
Yes. Just this suitcase. Give the claim tag to the young lady.
Oh.
Something the matter, miss?
Look!
What?
That's my bag.
He's got it.
Not that one, the other one. The one that looks just like it.
Where?
In the luggage compartment. You see it? It's already been loaded on the bus.
Who gave you that suitcase?
Which one?
With the red name tag on the handle, right there.
Some woman? I don't remember.
Try. What did she look like?
Well, it's hard to say. Half a dozen people lined up all at once.
Miss Barnes! Millicent! Wait! You just lie there for a while.
Oh, but I can't.
Yes, you can. I'll put my coat under your head.
On my way. You and the lady coming, or aren't you?
We'll wait for the next one.
Next one ain't due till 7 in the morning.
That's all right.
Got a long wait. Okay, we're on our way.
You want another wet towel for your forehead, honey?
What? Oh, no.
I'm shutting off some of the lights. When not in use, turn off the juice. That's what I always say.
Well, I'd better get home. I hope she feels better.
Thanks for your help.
It's all right, but offhand, mister, I'd say she needs some looking after. More than a towel for her head. You know what I mean?
Good night. How are you doing?
The bus.
It couldn't wait, but there'll be another one.
You didn't get on.
I don't care. I'm this late already. A few more hours won't make any difference.
It's quiet now.
Nice and restful. So you can just take it easy on this bench here. Keep your feet up.
Where are you going?
Nowhere. I'll sit on the other end.
Stay here. I wanted to tell you...
Yes?
What I've been thinking about.
Go ahead.
Something. It's very odd, but I've been remembering something I heard or read a long time ago. I don't know where... About different planes of existence. Different worlds that exist side by side.
How do you mean?
Parallel planes. That's what they call them. And each of us has a counterpart in this other world. And sometimes through some sort of freak occurrence, there's a break. And the two worlds converge. The counterpart steps outside into our plane. And to survive, it has to take over.
Take over how?
Replace us. Move us out so it can live.
That's a little metaphysical for me.
I remember reading it someplace. Each of us has a twin in this other parallel world. An identical twin. Maybe the one people saw tonight.
Millicent... There's another explanation. There's gotta be. An explanation that... Well... Something that has more reason to it.
I can't explain it, but... Somehow I know that's what happened. My counterpart, this other woman...
Forget about it. Please. Look, I just thought of something. I've got a good friend who lives in Tully. I'll call him and see if he can't bring his car down here for us. He could probably run us into Syracuse. I'll call him, all right, Millicent? Shall I call my friend?
I guess so.
Excuse me.
I'll tell you what I think. I think she's got a leak in her attic. Parallel planes, counterparts in another life. You got a thing for sick people? Is that it?
Poor kid. I don't know what's gonna happen to her.
You gonna call your friend?
What?
Your friend in Tully. The one with the car.
I don't have a friend in Tully. But she needs help, medical help. I figured it would be easier that way. I figured she'd come along if I told her that. Poor, poor kid. I don't know what else to do. Have you got a phone in there?
Who you want to call?
The police, I guess. They're the ones who'd know how to help her.
To tell you the truth, she kind of gives me the willies. I'd just as soon she get out of here one way or another. I don't much care how.
Where's your phone?
Come around to the office so she can't hear.
Okay.
Say, where'd she go?
What?
Take a look. She ain't on that bench no more.
Is anybody in there? Where are you? Where did you go? I know you're in here. Unless you really did get on that bus, but you didn't, did you? You're too clever for that. I only want to ask you a question. Then I'll go. Who are you really? And what do you want?
Millicent, are you in there?
Yes.
Oh, good. You had me worried there for a minute.
I'm fine.
I made the call. I just thought it's let up outside. How about a breath of fresh air while we're waiting?
All right. It's late.
Yes. Yes, it is. You know, sometimes, on a bad night, a person could use some help. Sometimes we all could.
You've been really nice. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Except that I do want to help you. Sometimes talking to someone can make all the difference. I may not have the answers you need, but there are people who do.
Why is that police car here? Is there trouble?
No trouble.
We'd better go inside.
Mr. Grinstead.
Yes.
You the one who called?
No, he didn't call you. Why would he call you?
Easy now, miss.
What are you doing? Get your hands off of me!
You know a place to take her?
Paul?
I think it's best if you go with them. No one's going to hurt you.
Paul!
Relax, lady. Come over to the car.
No! No, I won't! What are you doing?
Be careful with her. She's kind of fragile. A little confused, that's all.
Paul, don't let them take me! Why are you doing this?
I told you, be careful with her. She's not a criminal or anything.
Don't worry, Mr. Grinstead. We'll hold her for observation, get her some help. You did the right thing.
Stop! Let me go!
All right, come on. Just wait.
Okay,
here we go.
Get it all squared away?
Yeah, they're gonna take her to the hospital for observation.
What was she talking about anyway? All that business about another life?
I don't know. Part of her illness, I guess.
We've been driving for quite a while.
Miss?
Where are you taking me?
Don't worry, you're not going to jail.
This is all a misunderstanding.
The doctors will figure that out.
But I'm not sick.
Then you'll go on home.
I don't want to go home.
No?
I'm on my way to Buffalo. I have a new job there. Would you like to see the letter? It's in my purse.
Get your ID, too.
Certainly.
Let's have a look.
What happened back there, Miss Barnes?
Nothing.
Must have been something. Mr. Grinstead said you were upset, behaving irrationally.
Did he?
Said you had some wild story about people out to get you in the bus station?
Oh? Well, there were a couple of pretty unsavory characters hanging around. Haven't you ever been in a bus station?
He a friend of yours, Grinstead?
Not at all. I only met him a few hours ago.
And you thought somebody stole your luggage, got on the bus, tried to pass herself off as you?
Look, officer, it's really very simple. I haven't slept in almost 24 hours. I've been riding buses and it's raining and every connection is late. Wouldn't you be a little on edge?
That's no reason to run around disrupting the place, bothering everybody.
He tried to pick me up. That's why I was so upset.
Well, that's not what the station master said.
Well, what does he know? I mean, he's pretty peculiar himself. Stop the car right here and let me out. I'm begging you.
Sorry, can't do that.
Look, I'll take a cab all the way to Buffalo. Then none of you will have to put up with me anymore.
See, there you go.
There I go what?
You seem like a nice enough person. Why don't you just take it easy?
If you'd seen the things I saw, heard what I heard.
Calm down now and be a good girl, or I'll have to cuff you. You wouldn't like that now, would you?
Oh, you do that. Do it. Look, I don't care anymore.
I think you better let him check you out real good when we get to Braywood.
Braywood? What is that, a loony farm?
Emergency medical facility. They'll run some tests, see if you need any medication.
But my friend's waiting for me. What will she think if I'm not on the bus?
Your friend have a name?
Yes, of course she does. It's Judy Jensen. We've known each other since we were in school.
In Buffalo.
That's where the bus is going. I'm supposed to be on it. She was going to pick me up.
We'll get word to her.
Yes, do that. She'll tell you there's nothing wrong with me. One call, that's all I ask.
All units, possible robbery on Elm Street.
This is Unit 4.
South 2000 block at Mayfair. Are you in the area?
Negative.
Well, boys, somebody better Roger me fast, because I need a unit out there right now.
Why are you wasting your time like this when there's a crime going on? Look, I'm not violent. I've never been arrested in my life. And now you're probably going to cost me my job, when all you have to do is call my friend. Do you really want to drive around for another hour with someone in the backseat who's broken no laws while real criminals are running around on the streets?
Well, we'd have to fill out a report. A lot of paperwork. Be at the hospital till dawn.
We already have to fill out a report.
We could release her OR.
Then she goes right back to what she was doing, hurt herself or someone else?
In the friend's custody, I mean.
Your friend? She willing to drive out here and sign an affidavit?
Oh, I'm sure she would if you'd ask.
We could at least make the call.
This is Unit 4. Kelly, we're heading over to South Elm. Meanwhile, do me a favor. Patch me through to a Judy Jensen in Cortland.
I have your call, Unit 4.
Hello?
Miss Jensen?
She's gone to bed. Who's calling?
This is the Tully Police Department. Do you know a Millicent Barnes?
Yes, I'd say I do.
We have Miss Barnes here, and we were wondering...
Is this a crank call?
This is Lieutenant Anderson of the Tully PD. Miss Barnes says...
Oh, she does. Well, it just so happens that this is Millie Barnes, and I don't appreciate crank calls in the middle of the night, and neither does Judy. We just got in from the bus station, and if you don't mind, I'd very much like to take a hot shower and get some sleep. Is that all right with you? Good night.
No. 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 No.
You have any coffee?
Vending machine. Other side.
When's the next bus? 7 o'clock?
You got 4.5 hours. Take a snooze on the bench there if you want. You'll be all alone. No noise. I even shut off the video machine. This place is like a tomb between now and morning.
Thanks. I might do that.
You want to check your briefcase?
No, I'll keep it with me. Thanks. Hey, what's going on?
Nothing's going on. Thought you were going to take a nap.
I was about to, but I walk a few feet to the machine, turn around, and my briefcase is gone.
Well, sure it is.
What does that mean? Oh, dear Lord, she was right. And you're the one. It was you all along.
Hey, simmer down.
You're playing tricks, aren't you? Stupid, Hicktown tricks. Does that keep you from getting bored? Stealing people's luggage, moving it around, putting it back when they're looking the other way? Is that what all this is about?
The briefcase isn't there because you picked it up and brought it over here and walked out onto the platform.
I did that? You saw me?
Sure did. Same coat, same shoes, same everything. Didn't say a word. Only question is, How did you get back through that door without me seeing you? Of course, I was reading my magazine, so I guess I wouldn't have noticed.
Hey, who's out there? Hey, that's my briefcase! You, stop! Who are you? Where are you going? Please, what are you doing here? Tell me, I have to know! What do you want?
Obscure metaphysical explanation to cover a most disturbing phenomenon. Reasons dredged out of the shadows to explain away that which cannot be explained. Call it parallel planes, the myth of the doppelganger, or just plain old-fashioned insanity. But whatever you call it, you'll probably find more where that came from if you take a good look around the next time you're forced to spend a cold, wet, particularly inhospitable night at a bus station or some similar out-of-the-way place, one that's located just over the borderlines of the Twilight Zone.
Mirror Image, starring Morgan Brittany and Frank John Hughes with Stacey Keach as your narrator, was adapted for radio by Dennis Etchison and based on a script by Rod Serling. Heard in the cast were Peter DeFaria, Richard Hensel, Peggy Roeder, Adam Tangway, Roderick Peoples, Doug James, and Natalia Reed. The producers of The Twilight Zone wish to thank CBS Enterprises, Carol Serling, Dennis Etchison, Dick Brescia Associates, Claire Simon Casting, Paul Patch, Terry Jennings, the American Forces Radio and Television Service, our sponsors, and our radio affiliates for helping make this series possible. This radio series is produced and directed by Carl Amari and Roger Wolski for Falcon Picture Group. Doug James speaking.